here, and behind me is a 2013 Jeanneau 44 deck salon that is now available in Marina Del Rey, California. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this boat has to offer.
Okay, so here we are looking at Mojo, the 2013 Jeanneau 44 deck salon sailboat that is right here in Marina Del Rey, right behind the Marina Del Rey Hotel. Has an exceptional slip, easy access out into the water. This particular yacht is definitely packed with a lot of cool features. This is the deck salon. So what they've done is they've really raised up the cabin top. They've created larger windows, more overhead hatches. And by doing this, it allowed you to have a lot more interior volume. You're also gonna notice that the hard chine starts about midship and then carries back to the transom, giving you volume, stability that you're looking for. The tow rails on these particular yachts are composite. Even though they look like wood, they are composite tow rails. So we have entrance gates from both starboard and port side. And then again, this two-tone cabin top, which is quite nice. That is like a taupe type gel coat that they've used there. As we move our way to the transom of the vessel, you're gonna see a boarding ladder underneath this storage step here. We have emergency access here with this little pull-out clip, a large aft window that will also help ventilate the aft cabin. As we come on board the vessel, we have two lazarette lockers behind each helm seat. This lazarette locker houses the double propane. And then you have a large deep lazarette locker here. Also notice that all the sheets and halyards lead into these little cubbies where there are upgraded JL speakers in there. Off to the starboard side, we have our throttle controls, our upgraded engine panel here, also kind of showing us temperature and pressure, which is great. There is a windlass chain counter. So that allows you to control the windlass up and down from right there. We also have wind point, wind speed, autopilot. This is our compass, our VHF. Centrally located is our Simrad GPS plotter that's integrated with our radar midships up on the mast. And then off to the port side, we have a second multi-function display, a wind point, wind speed, compass. And then we also have really nice two-speed Harkin electric winches that will allow us to operate the jib sheet, the main sheet, and the spinnaker tack line. Now, what's nice about this boat is it's really set up for single-handed use. So you'd be going to the cabin top with the electric winch, unfurling the mainsail there, and then everything else is done from back here, which is quite nice. The cockpit itself is large. So the 44 deck salon, what they've done is they've raised up the vessel itself. They raised up the aft cockpit and they've stretched it out longer. So you have a really large cockpit that will, you know, pretty much rival most 49 foot vessels. As I mentioned, two speed electric winches, really nice, easy access up to the foredeck. As we move our way up to the foredeck, you can see our sheets and halyards also leading to the cabin top here. We have a double-ended main sheet that leads back to each helm, rigid boom vane, in-mast furling with a double spreader mast. Up at the top is wind point, wind speed, wind direction, VHF antenna. Then we have radar, deck light, and then we have our in-mast furling. These are brand new UK sails, both mainsail and head sail. So that is a really nice addition here. Moving up forward, really nice hatches here, all flush, really convenient for lounging. And then we have our anchor locker with electric windlass down here. Our delta anchor off to the starboard side, our second bow roller that's set up for the tack line. There is a furling asymmetrical spinnaker that goes with this vessel as well. So it has a great combination of both upwind and downwind sails. Talking about the upwind, we have inboard shrouds and we also have inboard sheeting here too. So you can see this is a really nice tight sheeting angle. This will allow you to really drive the vessel, you know, up into the wind. And again, just lots of great performance out of this. Taking another look at the cockpit here as we move our way back aft and around. Again, accessibility, ease of walking around this cockpit is quite nice. They've done the cockpit teak on the seating and then the floors here, and then up on the seating area, and then non-skid here on the floor. Lazarette lockers off to both starboard and port side, opening ports into the aft cabin. And then as we come up to the companionway, I mentioned the electric winch off to the port side, but we also have the sliding companionway door, sheets really nicely stowed in this area here. All right, as we come down below the vessel, we have the galley off to the starboard side. This is Jeanneau's kind of traditional L-shaped galley here. The galley's quite nice because we have a trash bin. This opens up to give us access to a little glove box and our electric switch for the salon table to raise it and lower it. It does lower down into a bed, and there are filler cushions for that. We have the double sink, kind of nice fixture here. This is the refrigerator. The refrigerator itself is quite deep, and it also has a freezer compartment just forward. Lots of storage here, two burner stove and oven, and then access into our aft master cabin, which I'll show you here in a bit. But again, good grab handles here, large windows. So this was kind of that advantage that I was talking about through the deck salon, and lots of overhead opening hatches. So you have 2, 4, 6 opening hatches in the salon. Directly across from us here, you can see the companionway steps coming down, access to the engine. We have a custom wine cooler, large nav station here. We have the inverter controls. We also have kind of our auxiliary docking station for the stereo, Fusion stereo. We have our 110 12-volt panels. This is the ICOM 504 VHF, a Sirius XM receiver. Just behind this cabinet, we also have the autopilot control remote here. So that's kind of a nice addition. All right, large bench seating off to the port side, large U-shaped seating off to the starboard side. As I mentioned, this really nice two-tone overhead hatches, built-in grab handles here, lots of ventilation. Coming up to the forward cabin, you have a grab handle here. Large mirror off to the starboard inboard side of it, full-length standing mirror. They have a desk vanity. Behind here, we have a hanging locker closet, lots of manuals, overhead opening hatches. Then you also have the side ports here. This is a nice V-berth. So again, traditionally heads down here, feet's there. And then you have, additional port with aviation shades, additional shelving locker there, in your own private head and shower compartment. So this is quite nice because you do have a plexiglass door that will close off this area. So it keeps this area, wet, and this area dry when taking a shower. I like it how they angle the mirrors as well too. So when you're actually using here, you can actually stand up straight to use it. But yeah, quite nice and a very respectable, VIP cabin. Lounge, seating at that angled, bolstering backrest here. Again, really nice table. This table is pretty unique. What I like about it is it actually will, there's a little lock pin. It'll pivot like so. And then this comes over, and so you can make it a full dining table. As I mentioned, it does go down into a bed, and or fold it back up. And then with a click of a pin, this will close off and make a nice area that you can kind of get around. Cabinets and storage throughout that area, all LED interior lights. Looking directly aft, we have the engine access here. So this just lifts up. We have access to our Yanmar engine. This particular engine was, serviced. The impeller was done 725-22. We have a Raycor, fuel filter system there, which is quite nice. And they've done some improvements to the sail drive, the previous owner, upgrading the cone clutch and what have you. Access to the day head or master cabin head and shower compartment. So here you have the electric toilets. They both have electric toilets, freshwater flushing. We do have the sink, the vanity. This is kind of a neat deal. This closes off so you can create more countertop space here. And then when not in use, it lifts up and pins into place. But behind this door, you have the plexiglass door that will enclose this shower area, keeping the rest of the head dry while you take a shower. Overhead opening hatch as well too. And then looking through to the aft master. So two entryways, one through the galley, one through the head. There is a bench seating on both sides of the bed. We have shelving here, lots of cabinets around, opening a cabinet there. Side hole port with aviation shades. This is an opening port that I showed you from the cockpit. But yeah, a really nice bed. This is, I would say, a modified king size bed, center line, which is very rare for a boat of this size. Nice walkway through. Underneath the bed here are all the batteries. And then this is access to the backside of the engine. This little area comes off right here. And then you can get to your sea strainer, your sail drive, and your cooling reservoir. All right, walking across here, and as I walk across here, you can see this bridge. This is where we stepped up to the companionway, but it gives you nice headroom. We have our breaker switches, battery switches underneath here. Nice bench seat, the same. Lots of storage, lots of hanging locker space and shelving here as well too. And then as we walk back through, we are into the galley and into this massive salon. Well, I hope you found this video walkthrough to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to Mojo, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you, hopefully earning your business. Thank you again. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for additional videos like this. Thank you again. Bye for now.